I'm singing in the rain, just singing in the rain. What a glorious feel, and I'm happy again.
I mean, I find it fun. I think it's such a classic movie that the fact of bringing it to life on the stage is so cool. It's difficult because people know the movie and they're expecting that, but we're trying to bring our own, you know, our own characters to it. And
yeah, I think you're right. I think that's something that I don't even think we even talked about or agreed on. It just kind of wasn't understood that our interpretations of the characters were our own interpretations. For me, the archetype still lives on. And then what I see Sarah doing, what I see Kevin doing, the archetypes that Gene Kelly, Donald O'Connor, and Debbie Reynolds established are very much alive in what they're doing. And there are moments where there may be a visual echo, if you will, a famous moment you'll see echoed in the show, but I think we've kind of individualized the characters themselves and individualized the language ourselves. There are a couple of things that are a little different than the movie. So there's an added song here and there. The Broadway melody number is orchestrated completely differently than in the film. But for me, going back to the original question, even though this is a stage musical based upon a movie that's based upon silent film, at its very core, it's an old-fashioned musical.
I think one of the things with Donald O'Connor is, you know, physically we're very different. Donald O'Connor was a nice, small, thin, you know, he's looked great. And not that I look bad, but it's just like, I'm sure I'm at least 60 or 70 pounds heavier than the guy. And so that's a big challenge. It's hard to imitate that and be able to do it in the same way. And so I'm constantly having to think that through. How can I do the part and not, and still be a funny part, still be very physically, a lot of physical humor. And I think that's the part that comes through a lot is, it's a physical part. I mean, it's really a physically funny part. I think one of the things that's great about the plays here and the musicals here, they have an audience they can pull from broadly, you know, with Sun City and Georgetown just here innately, that's willing to come to a lot of types of theater they aren't willing to do downtown, you know, down in Austin. The theater they do here is they're very willing to do a lot of big musicals, like Singing in the Rain. And so, which is exciting for people like us who love to sing and dance.
Good morning.
Good morning.
We've talked the whole night through.
Good morning.
Good morning to you.
It's because, like with Ron Watson, you're really committed to making sure the shows are fun. And it's not always the way it is in many theaters. They don't often care about fun, but this one they do. And one of the things that was particularly good with this show is I was able to do it with my son. So my son's in it. He's young Cosmo. I'm the old Cosmo. And so it's a little bit of a drag to bring my son here because he's a 13-year-old boy and he'd rather play basketball and all those kind of things. But he's a great tapper. So if you come see the show, you can see my son tapping. I won't say his name because it has to be incognito at Canyon Vista. No one needs to know. I've already given too much information.
Yeah.
Georgetown on February 24th and runs through March 25th. We have Friday, Saturday, and Sunday performances, and a few matinees on Saturdays thrown in there.
So to get tickets, you would go to, the best way to do that is to go to georgetownpalace.org and click Now Playing, and purchase your tickets online. It's a very easy process.